midst of a global tech rivalry, a new front has opened. Not with soldiers or missiles, but with silicon chips and algorithmic firepower. At the heart of this digital battlefield stand two titans, Huawei and Nvidia. Huawei, once a dominant force in global telecommunications, found itself abruptly cut off in 2019. The United States, citing national security concerns and alleged military links, blacklisted the Chinese firm, banning access to key American technologies and halting its smartphone momentum. The blow was severe, supply chains were disrupted, and the future of Huawei's global ambitions looked uncertain. But rather than retreat, Huawei re-engineered its strategy. Forced into a corner, it pivoted hard toward artificial intelligence. And now it's returning to the global stage with a new weapon, high-performance AI chips. Enter the Ascend 91B, followed by the even more powerful Ascend 91D. These chips represent Huawei's boldest step yet into the world of advanced computing. Designed and built under strict self-reliance, without U.S. components, they symbolize both technological resilience and national pride. Their mission? To challenge NVIDIA's H100, the reigning champion of AI hardware. NVIDIA's chips power everything from ChatGPT to cutting-edge research labs. But Huawei's new processors are narrowing the gap. In this silicon standoff, it's not just about performance, it's about autonomy, control, and who writes the next chapter of AI history. The race is on, and Huawei is no longer playing defense. The H100, NVIDIA's flagship AI chip, the beating heart behind large language models, generative AI, and some of the most powerful supercomputers on Earth. Its dominance is undisputed until now. Huawei's new chip, the 91D, is already being tested by some of China's biggest tech firms, including ByteDance, the company behind TikTok. The tests aim to measure whether the 910D can compete with NVIDIA's hardware in both performance and scalability. Early indicators suggest that Huawei is not merely catching up, it's closing the gap. This development has ignited optimism within China's tech sector, which has long been hampered by foreign dependencies. What makes the Ascend 910D special? Huawei's engineers have turned to an innovative approach called chiplet design, essentially combining multiple smaller chips into a single package. This lets them boost processing power and overcome limitations of a single monolithic die. More power, though, means more heat. Huawei's chip reportedly consumes more energy than NVIDIA's H100, and that could pose limitations in large-scale data centers. Still, performance is performance, and China is watching closely. The stakes? Technological sovereignty. In a world increasingly driven by artificial intelligence, control over the hardware that powers it is paramount. For China, being dependent on US-based NVIDIA has been a vulnerability, one the government is eager to eliminate. Huawei's success is more than corporate, it's political. In Washington, alarm bells are ringing. Earlier this year, NVIDIA CEO Jensen Huang met with US lawmakers, voicing concerns about Huawei's rapidly advancing AI capabilities. The fear? That continued sanctions may be driving US rivals to innovate faster and smarter out of necessity. Because when you cut off access to top-tier tech, you don't always slow progress. Sometimes you ignite it. Since the Trump administration's decision to blacklist Huawei, the US has tightened its grip. Export bans have been expanded to include advanced GPUs like NVIDIA's A100 and H100. China responded by investing heavily in its domestic chip industry, billions of dollars in subsidies, research, and partnerships. Today, those investments are beginning to bear fruit. The government's push for tech independence has become a national mission, echoed in every university lab and corporate boardroom. The 910D isn't Huawei's first attempt at an AI chip, but it is its boldest. Built entirely without US components, this chip represents a technological and symbolic milestone. It's a declaration that Huawei is back in the race, and perhaps even leading it on some fronts. Analysts believe the chip could become the foundation of China's future in AI, robotics, surveillance systems, and national defense tech. Already, government contracts are lining up, giving Huawei's chip a guaranteed home inside Chinese infrastructure. Behind the scenes, Huawei has quietly restructured its entire chip supply chain. From advanced packaging to software stacks, The company is piecing together what many thought was impossible without U.S. support. Insiders describe a culture of urgency within Huawei's R&D labs, where engineers work around the clock, motivated not just by profit, but by national pride. It's not just about raw power, it's about ecosystem. Nvidia has CUDA, TensorRT, and a massive developer community. Huawei has to build all that from scratch. But remember, China has its own ecosystem now. They're creating alternatives at every layer: software, cloud infrastructure, data centers. It's like a parallel tech universe. The worry is that if Huawei can produce high-end chips domestically, then export controls lose their leverage. Across China, a network of state-supported firms are racing to eliminate reliance on foreign technology. Companies like iFlytek and SenseTime are early adopters of Huawei's chips. The goal? An end-to-end Chinese AI stack, hardware, software, and data, all made in China. Huawei is also developing its own alternative to CUDA, known as CAN, and pushing developers to adopt the Mindspore AI framework. It's a difficult path, but one with strategic value beyond the tech world. Every piece of the puzzle that China builds domestically brings it one step closer to complete digital autonomy. For U.S. officials, Huawei's resurgence isn't just a tech story, it's a security threat. The concern: if Huawei's chips power Chinese AI in surveillance, defense, or propaganda, the geopolitical consequences could be enormous. In the new Cold War of computing, every chip is a chess piece, and Huawei is making a bold move with its queen. What about performance? Sources familiar with Huawei's internal testing suggest the Ascend 910D may not match the H100 in every metric. No more dependency on Nvidia. No more waiting for Washington's export approval. This isn't just a matter of competition. It's about contingency planning, strategic resilience, and national sovereignty. A digital firewall is quietly being constructed, not to block information from flowing in or out, but to ensure that the core of China's AI ecosystem, its computing power, remains under Chinese control. Meanwhile, Nvidia remains dominant for now. With a market cap surpassing $2 trillion, it powers most commercial AI deployments across the globe. Its chips are the backbone of innovation, from startups to research labs, fueling everything from chatbots to autonomous vehicles. But Huawei's rise introduces a critical inflection point. Its chips may not outperform Nvidia's today, but they're good enough. And good enough is powerful when geopolitical restrictions make the best unavailable. Some are now asking, did U.S. efforts to contain China's tech ascent end up accelerating it? Silicon may be microscopic, but its consequences are colossal. In this new era of digital geopolitics, supremacy isn't about tanks or treaties. It's about transistors. The true war is for control over the future of intelligence. And that war is being fought one chip at a time. This is the age of the Silicon Showdown, and the race has only just begun. This is the age of the Silicon Showdown, and the race has only just begun. Thanks for watching. If you want to stay informed about the latest breakthroughs and rivalries in the global tech war, make sure to like, subscribe, and stay tuned to our channel. More updates are on the way.